Well, good morning, Moose. Well, I appreciate your dedication in eating my hay. I'd really appreciate if you go away. Go on. You can tell it's not the mom because this one's still scared of me. Mom would have just stood there and continued to eat. Go on. Get. Go on. Now I'll let out the dogs. So good morning, everybody. So today is Saturday, but I couldn't tell you the date. The girls have officially been in here 2 weeks. And although udders are getting bigger, I haven't had any show or sign or discharge or anything like that. Now I go back to work in a week and a half. So they better get busy. I thought I had Luna in labor last night. She had a little bit of discharge, which wasn't normal. Her udder has kind of sort of grown about half of what it was when I first showed you. So one at a time, like half again what it was, but nothing. She did a little bit of grunting, but there were no contractions. I was in here for about 3 hours last night with her. I separated her and Liz. Here, I'll show you. Hey, Liz. How are you, my girl? I just put up I guess it's just a dog gate thing. Didn't I? I did. So I did. I gotta go in there and clean her area out. She did a lot of pooping last night. I gave her more space than I gave Liz because Liz comes out every morning with me regardless. Don't you, my girl? Don't you? And she comes out when I was doing feeding last night and walked around. Because she follows me. So, like, I can call her name and she'll actually respond to it. I would say probably 50% of the time. It's not like a dog. But Luna, I've stopped bringing her up on the stand, even though she's taking it really easily and she's learning it really good. Kind of just stopped doing it because it was just adding some stress and we just didn't need to do that. So I'll start doing it again after she's kitted out. We'll see how well that works. Hi. How are you? She's like in my pocket almost all the time. I could come and sit here for probably, well, like last night I was sitting in Liz's stall for 3 hours and she just kind of almost like on my lap. She's not light anymore with these babies in her. There you go. Hi, my baby. Yeah. Turn this thing off. There we go. Take it off there. Oh. Well, it's minus 6 in here right now. So it's cold, but it's not horrible. I've got the stove going. I'll stoke that up here in a bit. I've got some pretty big pieces of wood. Before Graham left for the weekend, he chopped me up, boxed me up some wood. Oh, I gotta get her some water. But I went through that pretty quickly. So Travis came over and he helped me do more. This is hard to do one-handed. You just stay there, Liz. Come on, move over. Thank you. Liz, stay in here.
Oh, crap.
So he helped me do it. And then, so I've got enough now for at least 2 days. I'll have to get some more probably in the next day or so. But it's supposed to warm up again. Be at least in the positives at night. So I'm hoping that happens. but with everything, I managed yesterday to get my kitchen sink plumbed. I did it without going to the hardware store more than once. I did it without any bashed fingers. And I'm pretty proud of myself. It was wasn't my typical plumbing job where I had to go to the store 15 times because I forgot something. I had everything, got it done, nothing leaks, pretty happy. So got running water right now, cold running water. Graham has to install a filter. So once the filter's been installed, we'll hook up the hot water tank. But until then, we'll just keep with the cold water. At least I have the ability to wash my hands. I still have to boil water to wash dishes and stuff, but that's okay. I can live with that. I've got cold water. So, yeah. I still won't drink it. It's still pretty dirty and mucky. So, like I said, Graham's got to put on the filter and stuff. But you know what? It doesn't stink like the house in Enderby. It doesn't smell like sulfur. We did have the water tested. It's high in iron, high in sodium. So those two things, that's fine. Again, we'll get the filters and get that all taken out. And yeah. So, hi Liz, you gonna help me stoke the fire? So I gotta stoke this fire. See, she's basically in my pocket. And get out and deal with the duck.
Be nice to me, Speedy.
That was the nicest he's been in a week. Yeah, that was nice of you. Thank you.
Are the girls coming out? Oh, there they are. It's almost bedtime and I'm watching the video camera and I'm checking on all the goats. And you know, everybody has that one kid that doesn't matter what you do, they're just gonna be defiant. And every single time I turn around, Liz is eating the wood in her stall. And watch this. I'm gonna talk to her, watch. Liz, leave that alone. Leave it, Liz. Good girl, you leave it alone. That's a good girl. Hi, Liz. That's a good girl. You leave it alone. Yeah, I'm watching you, you little sprat. And she'll do that. She'll leave it alone now for probably about 5 minutes. And then she'll go right back to chewing it again. But she's looking at me like up at the camera going, I know you're watching me, Mom.
I know. Just turn your back. Go do dishes. But really, look at that face. How could you say no? She's such a brat. Anyway, good night, everybody. I hope you had a wonderful day. It was busy around here. We got a lot done. Speedy didn't attack me when I gave him water today, so that was awesome. Packed a bunch of wood, stacked it, took the dogs for a walk. Tomorrow I need to move more hay into the barn, kind of get it out of the moose's grasp. And my fridge and stove show up tomorrow, so that's exciting. Anyway, hope you had a great weekend. Talk to you soon.